waves. The second round of the Moto3 World Championship about to get underway. Lights out. Good start from Rodrigo. Good start from Massia on pole as well. Here are the Magnificent Seven then charging from the pit lane start, led by Sergio Garcia. Bit the challenges for the lead and goes through the South African number 40 on the Petronas Sprinter Honda. Darren Binder leads.
And look at that. The pit lane starters just trying to pick them out in the background. They'll be coming through the shot very, very quickly.
Yeah, they have a lot of work to do. Jaume Massia trying to retake the lead of this race. Migno it is across the line. Who will lead? And they're kicking off dust. And Massia there. I think Matt just clipped the side and onto the Astro turn. 10 bikes abreast this heading into turn one. This is crazy.
This is watching through your fingers, isn't it, this one? Suzuki on the inside.
Oh, contact. First faller of the day we have, and it's Artigas. Salah is down. Salah, after what was looking like being his best ever evening of Moto3 racing, he's gone out of the race. He was trying to go around the outside of the Yumi Sasaki. Was there contact? Yes, there was. A little bit of a nudge there.
These are the 21 riders that started on the grid.
The gap then from Fillon in 21st back to the seven riders that started from pit lane is 8.7.
The pit lane starters, that gap's dropping quite dramatically while this group beat each other up at the front. Acosta now is only 6.8 seconds away from what was the race leader, Philip Salac. Acosta, 5.5 seconds behind your race leader, creeping ever close to the back of this pack. There he is on the 37 bike. He's still got Venati, Garcia and Nepa right on his case as well. There is Pedro Acosta. He's right four on this group now. The pit lane starters, all four of them, are here and to play in the lead group.
McPhee's
gone down again. Oh, John McPhee, how is your luck in 2021?
Let's watch this again. Now, keep an eye specifically on Darren Binder on the left, number 40. He just drifts out there. There's contact. You're right. Not quite back tire, but there's contact. That you cannot blame Alcova for that.
But McPhee can see it coming.
That nearly clatters.
Oh,
it does. He gets a whack in the head as well. Two laps to go. Massia leads, but for how long? Through goes Gabriel Rodrigo. He now takes the lead of the race on the inside. Look at Acosta. He's up into the podium places, although squeezing him out is Darren Binder. Here is Pedro Acosta, who we remind you started this race from pit lane.
I think the boy's got
there
some talent, and he's through on Binder. Through on Binder, Acosta up into third place.
Oh, look at that, up the inside. He's not scared of his own teammate.
Pedro Acosta, he started from pit lane. He's about to lead the Doha Grand Prix with one lap to go. Astonishing here in the Middle East. He does lead. On the first lap, Pedro Acosta was 9 seconds off the lead group. And on the last lap, he leads. And he's got the hammer down. He's already trying to put a bit of daylight between himself.
This would be one of the greatest Grand Prix victories in history, folks.
A rookie sensation, not half. Can you believe what we're witnessing here in Qatar?
He's got it!
He's got it! Unbelievable! Wow! Pedro Acosta. What an unbelievable Grand Prix. He has won a truly remarkable Tissot Grand Prix of Doha by 0.03 of a second. He started from pit lane.
If you enjoyed the video, subscribe, turn on your notifications to never miss a video.